So let's remember how we defined our ranking function. So we said we're going to have a time step. We're going to keep going through steps to get more accurate rankings. But initially, we're going to give every rank 1 divided by the number of pages. Before I call that capital N, I'm going to use N pages as a more Pythonic variable name for that. And we updated the rank at time step T by adding the probability that the random surfer starts over and randomly picks that page. So that's 1 minus D is the probability of starting over divided by N pages, how many pages there are. And remember that D is our damping constant, and we'll decide that D is 0.8. That's the damping constant. We add to that the sum that we get of all the ranks, all the pages that link to this URL. We add up D times the previous iteration. So it's going to be D times rank on step T minus 1 of that page, but we want to divide that by the number of outlinks from P. So it's starting to look more like Python code. We want to simplify it a little bit before we get to Python code. And the first thing we're going to do to simplify it is observe that, well, we have this T parameter, but we only ever use the very previous one. So we don't really need to keep track of the rank value for all the different T values. We just need to keep track of the previous one. When we did Fibonacci, we kept track of current and next in variables, and that allowed us to keep track of the previous and the previous Fibonacci numbers. What we want to do with ranks is something similar. So we're going to use the variable ranks to keep track of the current ranks. And as we compute the new ranks, we're going to use the variable new ranks. So we'll use ranks. This corresponds to the ranks at time t minus 1, the ranks at the previous iteration, and we'll have a variable new ranks, which is the ranks at time t. And the reason we need both of those, as we update the rank from each page, so we're going to go through the pages, recomputing its rank, we can't lose the previous one. We still need to get rank at the previous step for that page. If we use the one that we got this time, that would distort the results. It would mean that the order that we update the ranks for changes the results. So we don't want the results to depend on the order that we go through the pages. That's why we need to keep track of both the previous values, which will be used for ranks t minus 1, and the new ranks. Once we've done that, we don't need the t parameter anymore. What we're going to do is change this rank. The rank at time t is going to be the value of new rank, and the value of rank at time t minus 1, that's the value of ranks. The other change I slipped into this, before we had parens here, and I've changed them to square brackets, and square brackets should give you the idea that, well, this might be a data structure that we're indexing, and that's correct. We want to index the data structure, and we want to index it by the URL that we're looking for. And the Python dictionary provides a great way to do that. At the end of this will be a Python dictionary, and that's exactly what we want. So I think we're ready to start looking at the code. We've written this formula. It's still a mix of math and Python, but we're going to turn this into the code for computing the page ranks.